Welcome back, guys. We have a new dynasty. We're playing with Connecticut this time, and we decided to shrink down from three dynasties to just this one. We've got 11 guys all in and getting ready to roll here, about to kick off our season with the Connecticut Huskies. Come back later on. I'll give you a little tour of the dynasty and who all's in it, or what all teams that we have, and kind of some of the players and guys that we have rejoining and joining back and continuing with the dynasties that we're doing here. As you can see, we're playing as CukooCactus6, a guy I played against quite a bit in previous dynasties. Boiler has Western Michigan, I have UConn, and we're playing here today at my home field. And, yeah, man, it should be a pretty solid game, not too even. I've got the better team, but it's new, so anything can happen. Hopefully we can start this thing off right. We've got a very tough non-conference schedule ahead of us, so getting a win today would be huge for us, trying to get to 10 wins on the season. So that's kind of our goal this year, as every year, is to get to 10 wins. And once we get to 10 wins, obviously we want to win our conference. And then once we win our conference, we would like to see about winning maybe a BCS Bowl if we can get lucky enough to do so. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and see what we can do here with our new team and see if we can't start this season off right. And they get a 6-yard gain on the first play from scrimmage. Knew they were going to run the ball, just couldn't stop it. So it's going to be 2nd down and 4. He's played with Western Michigan before. He's done pretty good with Western Michigan too in the past. So he's worked with his team. I haven't quite worked with UConn since maybe the 2010 game, when I did a little bit of work with them in offline work, but not anything online. She gets 10 yards on that reception and a first down. Oh gosh, it's going to be a little bit of a learning curve with these teams. Usually with me, it takes a couple weeks to kind of get used to it, but especially when it's a new team like this. But just got to just kind of got to cowboy up and make it happen, man. Wow, I got just absolutely destroyed off the line that time. And he gets 12 yards on another 1st down and 10. He's got a little drive going here. And a tackle after getting 8. It's going to be 2nd down and 2. Ball at 38 now. He's kind of having his way here early. And it's 4-yard receptions, 1st down and 10. He likes those underneath routes big time. I gotta find ways to get pressure on him because he's getting rid of the ball pretty fast.
1st down, 10 to go. Ball on 34.
And we're gonna stop that one for a loss of 3. 2nd and 13. Just got to keep the pressure on him now. Big hit after an 11-yard reception. It's going to be 3rd down and 1. Ken says, kick his ass, boy. Cool. 4 yard run is first down and 10. Defense has got to get it in the gear here if we want to stop them.
Gets it to his
and another underneath route. Who would have thought? 10-yard receptions, first down and 10. Starting with 5. And a touchdown for Western Michigan. 11 yards. That's going to be 6-0. Western Michigan rolls right down the field with little struggle at all. Against UConn's defense. We're going to have to grind this one out. Defense is just rough right now. He's got me on my heels. So here comes UConn. 4 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first.
He sends this one deep.
Oh man, you may as well just not even fucking touch it. What are you doing? Get underneath the fucking ball. First down and 10. Ball to 25.
The offense taking the field for the first time today.
You already know how we do. Gonna go with a run file on first down, and we get 17 yards, first down and 10. We're gonna put pressure on him to hurry up here.
Defense to pay more attention to the run. That creates chances in the play action passing game. Looks like they're trying to catch the defense off guard here.
And he's got room to run, and he is gone. Second play from scrimmage, and UConn answers. 58-yard touchdown by Damian Lewis, and UConn brings it within one. Wow. A great first offensive possession of the year. Two plays, 75 yards, 14 seconds, two run plays. And UConn ties it up. 4:06 left in the first.
They line up to kick this one away.
Oh, goodness.
He's to the 20. He's tackled.
Tackled just shy of the 30, and it's going to be first down and 10 for Western Michigan from there. Intercepted by Davis, and I don't know if he was tackled or whatever, but we forced a turnover there, and it's going to be first down and 10. Ball at 37 for UConn. Smith inside, who gets down inside the 20, and it's going to be first and 10 for UConn. Who's going to go with the hurry up again? And he's got Howard at the 3, touchdown, UConn, 17 yards, and it's 13-7. Huskies up. With another quick touchdown following the interception. This time, 3 plays, 36 yards, and 8 seconds.
He splits the uprights with an extra point.
And UConn cashes in on the turnover and takes a 14-7 lead. Tackle just shy at the 15. First down and 10. Just catch it and take it for Western Michigan. Only way to guarantee that your offense will start on the 20.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play.
Woo, 15-yard run on first down. Western Michigan is rolling again after the interception. Almost intercepted by Savoy, and it's going to be second down and 10 for Western Michigan. Loss of 10, and it's third down and 20 for Western Michigan. Ball at the 19-yard line.
Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of it.
Almost intercepted by Scott, and it's going to be fourth down and 20 for Western Michigan with 2:28 left here in the first quarter. They got the ball on the 19, so you assume that they're going to punt. I mean, they almost have to. Looks like they're coming after the punt, too. It's going to be down at about 35. My goodness. First and 10 ball at the 34-yard line. Come back out looking for more of the same. You know, when this defense went over to the sideline based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator. Oh, gosh, that was a terrible read and loss of four. Second down at 14.
Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Connecticut is up 7.
He's going to hit Goolsby over the middle. 17 yards, first down at 10 for UConn. Trouble for Western Michigan, and they get him after a 2-yard gain, second down at 10. He had the edge for a second, but they closed fast. Ball's at the 50 now. Second down and 8 for UConn.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 50.
Oh boy, they're on the counter. Oh man. And he makes another man miss, and Lewis has the edge. He's at the 20, the 15, 10, 5, and he gets pushed out of bounds at about the 3-yard line. Another big gain, and it's first and goal for UConn. Ball at the 3. And and he hits Howard, who's wide open for a 3-yard touchdown pass, and it's going to be 20-7 UConn with a minute and 8 seconds left in the first quarter. Minute 17 on that drive. Took a little bit longer for the Connecticut Huskies. And they're going to be up by 2 touchdowns. A minute and 8 seconds left in this game. I mean, a quarter. Yard return, and it's going to be 1st and 10 for Western Michigan. Ball at the 24. It's probably going to feel like he needs to pass here. He really doesn't. It's only the first quarter. He could still get a couple stops in this game. But he has a tendency to put a little bit of stress on himself. There he goes. And 7 more yards. It's going to be 2nd down and 3. If he doesn't abandon his run, he can stay in the game. If he can just maybe force a couple mistakes while I'm on offense, he's still in it. I mean, he's not out of it by any means. He's just one slip play on defense and a couple of really good defensive plays of his own, and I get another sack. It's going to be 3rd and 11 now for Western Michigan. But he's still in it. I mean, 2nd and short after a good run on 1st down. I don't know why you're not trying to run it and get it out to the edge on me, but that's going to be the end of the first quarter. And UConn up 21-7 over the Western Michigan Broncos.
And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2.
Ooh, nice little play there, and he gets a receiver wide open in the middle of the defense. It's 22 yards, and 1st down and 10 for Western Michigan. The quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
.177 total yards to .99.
Sandwiched between 2 defenders after an 8-yard reception. It's going to be 2nd down and 2.
And
he gets the 1st down. 1st down and 10 for Western Michigan.
And 10, ball on the 44-yard line.
Ooh, drop pass, and it's going to be 2nd down and 10. Had that guy open on an underneath route. He loves the underneath stuff. Like, he lives there all day. Which is fine if you can do it effectively like he can, but, man, I mean, it's just so frustrating as a defensive player, though.
And another drop. Had him wide open between about 3 defenders. It's going to be 3rd down and 10. That guy should have had that one. No excuse for that drop. Not helping him out. He's got a good little drive going. It could kill it on stuff like that.
Here's the 8th play of the series. He's going to try and scramble.
Oh man, another drop, and he had a guy open again. God, he's got to be frustrated as hell right now. I feel bad for him. He's throwing 2 really good balls back to back, and they just dropped them. 100% not even his fault. Like, that was trash. His receivers should have caught those passes, but it's 4th and 10. He's probably going to go for it now. I mean, he has to, basically.
It's 4th down on the offense.
He,
he really
has to if he wants to stay in the game.
Come out in a 5-wide set. He chucks it downfield.
Oh, my God. I can't believe that. I had a guy on him and everything. I mean, he deserves that first down just because his receivers were, like, dropping the ball big time. So, I mean, I'm not even mad about that. But it's going to be 1st and goal from the 9. All square. And now I want to make him cry and keep him out of the end zone. So, 1st and goal from the 9.
The 10th play of the drive. And they'll run him again. Tackle left side.
2nd and goal.
Second down. Defense stacked in tight here.
Ooh, touchdown, 3 yards, and it's going to be 21-13. UConn still in the lead with 4 minutes and 8 seconds left. So there's two things I could do here. I could try to score quick again, but he'll probably use up the rest of the half and keep it at a one possession game. Or I could sit on the ball for 4 minutes and I could score as time expires and then get the ball back at the half. Guess what I'm going to do? I can make this a 3-possession game easy right now just by doing that. But we'll just see how the kickoff goes.
Excellent kick.
Because, yeah. There ain't no motherfucking way I'm bringing that out. So 1st and 10, ball at the 25. UConn up by 7.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Connecticut is up a score.
Running. Oh boy. Oh no. Oh boiler. Another big run game by Damian Lewis, and it's 1st down and 10. That's our 2 o'clock right here. Lewis gets 8 yards. It's going to be 2nd down and 2. He about broke it again. Look at this, 154 yards in one half. One half of football he's done that. That's incredible.
Pitches back.
Oh man, Goolsby. Goes for 8 more. It's 1st down and 10 for Connecticut.
Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
I could take his knees out with play action right now, but
ball on the 32.
My run game's going really, really well. I don't really want to. No gain, and it's going to be 2nd down and 10 for Connecticut.
About 2 minutes before halftime. Pitches it. He's got the corner.
And 3rd and inches, he gets 10 yards. Under a minute and a half left in the first half.
So it's 3rd down, and they're just inches away from picking up the 1st down. Connecticut is up by a touchdown.
have a lane, 5 yards, and it's going to be first down and 10 for you. Be up the middle, running men over. 12-yard run, and it's first and goal, 25 seconds left. He's going to hit Thompson. Touchdown, 27-14 UConn. That's Tim Russell's third touchdown pass of the half. Less than 100 yards passing, and it's 27-14, and they use all up 21 seconds left in the half. We'll see what Western Michigan's going to do before time runs out. See if they're okay with going into the half down only two possessions. Yard return. There's 17 seconds left in the half, and UConn is up 28-14. Whew. We'll see what happens here.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He lets it fly.
Oh my God! He dropped it in the basket. I had a guy there, too. I tried to jump the route too quick. And 12 seconds left. He's probably going to field goal out of this. Ball's at the 32-yard line. Why not? Shit. Good shit, man. That was a good fucking play. Oh! Incomplete. It's going to be second down and 10. I had another play on it. I couldn't get my guy to jump. Second to 10 with 8 seconds left.
He throws it.
Oh man. Good grief. He's just making really good plays right now. For everything he's done passing the ball, I've done running the ball. So it's just been tit for tat right now.
It's first down. So inside the five with a first and goal. It put everyone up on the line.
Oh, boy. He took a risk. Should have just taken the point spoiler. But it's going to be 28-14 at the half. And UConn gets the ball on the other side. Already up by 2 touchdowns. So he's going to go ahead and kick it off regular. Jones to return this one. We'll see what we got in our return guy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh gosh, he just didn't have enough juice. But he gets across the 50-yard line. He's going to be first down at 10. I already know what I'm doing. To open up the half. It's time to come out guns blazing. We've set the tone early with the run game. So what do you think that they're going to be talking about in the half? How about got to stop the run game? So we're going to hit them first play of the half. How about a play action down the field? And oh shit, intercepted. Nice. Man. Gave a 50-50 ball to our receiver, and he couldn't bring it in. Great play by Boiler, and it's going to be first and 10 for Western Michigan. Like I said, if he could force some turnovers, make a couple plays on defense, something could happen, but we'll see if he can finish it. Incomplete. Second to him.
Saw the blitz coming and just got rid of the ball to avoid losing yards.
to that quickly. He's taken down.
He knew he was going over there. It's the same thing. He does it every single game. It's going to be second down at 6.
From their own 41-yard line, it's second down.
Oh, no. Come on.
He's at midfield.
Oh, crap. First down and 10 for Western Michigan. Good grief. I just got all miscombobulated on that play. He's doing a good job of mixing it up.
And it looks like they might be bringing some pressure here. Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down.
Bad defensive play call that time. Like I said, he's mixing it up really good and getting me good and confused. Not keeping it, it's not being predictable. But then he'll have his moments where he is. It's just, it's weird.
From the 25-yard line, first down.
Run play, right? Nope.
Open field. Knocked out of bounds.
Oh,
at
man,
the 16.
I tell you what. Second down and one.
That brings up second and one. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
Third down and 3. Oh, goodness.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Strike complete. Brought down around the 15-yard line.
Underneath route again. Surprise, surprise.
First and 10. Ball on the 15. Fires out to his wide out. Tackle around the 6-yard line.
Eating me up underneath. I mean, big time.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
He tackles him up. Third down and 3. Broken up, and it's going to be 4th down and 3 for Western Michigan. Just got to make one more play right here. Come on. Come on. One more play.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
Tackle. Good grief. I get so tired of that, man. He's just so good at it.
points in their short yardage package.
Brought him down. He stopped short. Well, oh, coming. Second down and goal. All three.
Second down, goal to go. 3 yards for the touchdown.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, how did I stop that? Again, underneath route, underneath route, underneath route. Everything's underneath.
And this is the 16th
play. That's in the third quarter. He uses up basically the whole entire freaking quarter sitting on the ball, doing a good job. I mean, milking the clock and playing underneath. I didn't deserve that quarter. I didn't deserve to win that quarter, but he did. And, I mean, he made me pay for it.
Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. And the goal line defense digging in here. Touchdown,
oh, my
Broncos. Well, the comeback is alive.
So it's
going
to be 28-20. And Western Michigan is going to be within a touchdown with 7 minutes left in the fourth. And it's going to be 28-21 with 7 minutes left. And that interception is just becoming bigger and bigger now that we got that. First and two ball. I had one possession of that board. Like, really let that sink in. That was really, really good offensive control by Boiler. But this is just going to be a wide open receiver right here. First down, two.
Connecticut is up 7.
He gets I got sacked. Second down, 19.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play. Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation.
Williams, first down 10.
First down. Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Oh, dropped a touchdown right over the middle. Second down and 10. Ball to 36. That hurts. That one stung, but
from the 36-yard line, second
there
down.
Go. Wide open, hits Smith, and it's going to be first down 10.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down. He's in trouble.
Second down and 10.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight. That
makes it 7-10. How about we use his own thing against him here?
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 18. Connecticut up 7 points.
touchdown, and it's going to be 34-21 Utah. 5:42 remaining. Oh my God.
They must have been thinking they'd catch him off guard and have a chance to cushion their lead.
But maybe I can get him to take a shot to the end zone here and pick the ball off. Guys to come back.
When you're a quarterback and you start this close to the end zone, your eyes just light up when you take the field. Conversely, the defense is thinking, we can't let him get another one so quickly.
Fires it out. He's tackled at the 14-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want it.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. And he shoved out of bounds right around the 6-yard line.
And he gets a touchdown. It's going to be 35-27. Oh, God. Boiler. It's 35-28. UConn 18.
Remaining in the fourth quarter. And the score is Connecticut 35, Western Michigan 28.
Do it yet. Oh,
this is strange. The kicking team is looking to kick the onside, but the return team's in their normal kick return formation. Dingo needs a good bounce for a possible recovery here. He's tackled at the 40. They don't recover the onside, so they'll really be counting on their defense to come up with a turnover in order to win this thing.
Well, this is the biggest series of the game. A stop here, and they're back in business. But if they give up a touchdown, it's all over.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. And he's tackled at the 15-yard line.
First and 10.
Up a score.
Oh my gosh, dropped another touchdown. Second down and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 15-yard line. Quick pass. Big open.
Touchdown, Utah.
Touchdown, Connecticut.
41-28.
To the 10. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Last drive ended with
result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
Oh, boy. I don't know why you're running. It's 4 minutes left. You're down by two touchdowns.
Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And down he goes around the 48-yard line. From the 48-yard line, it's first down. He's going to try and scramble. Slings it out, and it gets tipped.
This is a well-prepared defense. They know where to be, and they know what their opponent likes to do. They play tight coverage as well.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. And a quick throw. The 10. They bring him down, but not before he gets a glimpse of the end zone.
This is just an incredible pass and catch for the huge...
He continues to just drag all day long with absolutely no issue. And it's frustrating.
Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. And touchdown. Big touchdown.
7-point game again.
Game.
I'm just going to keep scoring. I'm just padding my offensive stats, honestly. I don't even care. I'm going to keep doing it until it gets to a point where I can't anymore. And then I'm just going to milk the clock, so...
With that onside kick, now all the pressure goes to the defense to make a stand.
They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right
inside the five, and it's going to be first down and goal.
Getting the football out of his hands, but he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this team.
Connecticut is up by a touchdown. Throws it to the halfback on the screen.
Touchdown, UConn. 48-35.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. They come out of an empty backfield.
Ugh. So 3:05 left, and it's 48-35. I just want to get the half 100. Oh my.
Well, it's safe to say that this coach obviously is not a big fan of field position.
Well, not only is this decision mind-boggling, but it also shows a lack of sportsmanship. When you have the lead, you don't kick onsides.
Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. Just under three to go in regulation. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's taken down at the 19.
My pass defense just looks absolutely atrocious right now.
Some time. Slings it. Tackle made at the 12-yard line.
Clock is still ticking.
That'll bring up second and three. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Hit and still completed it. Touchdown, Broncos.
Oh, goodness. This is being way more stressful than it needs to be.
And he hits the PAT.
I should be up there just right now, but I screwed around and tried to be a dick at the beginning of the half and threw that interception.
And now the game's probably in their hands. If they can hang on to the ball or score, I don't see how they can lose.
Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership. It to the back.
To the tail. Oh boy.
Touchdown Huskies.
Rushing from the running back.
Offensively, the question is, can the defense hold on here in the fourth quarter? They'll go for two in this situation. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what they do.
Touchdown for 2 points, and it's going to be 56 to 42.
A low line drive. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 48. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
Not a whole lot of time left in this game, Brad. They've got to score down two possessions, and they need to score as fast as they can and then recover an onside kick and hope to be able to have a shot to tie this game.
The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator is going to be delivered.
Jesus Christ.
He's got to challenge them.
I need DB so bad.
Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's.
He He's probably throwing for like 500 yards on me. This is just sad, sad.
Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Second and goal, ball on the 3-yard line, and the goal line defense digging in here. Looks to a receiver, touchdown! The huge pass and catch for the touchdown, and now we're down to a one-score game.
Ooh.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So with just over a minute to go here in the fourth quarter, our score
probably been
in
like
56.
30, 28 points each scored this half. I mean, this quarter, that's ridiculous.
Tackle made the 38-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Russell off the fake. Fires incomplete, knocked away. From the 38-yard line, it's second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he's taken down at the 19-yard line. A little over a minute in the game. He's got to throw it in a hurry. He's wrapped up for the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
To go.
Oh my God, come on.
The clock will stop with that incompletion.
I don't understand that strategy at all. With the lead late in the game, you just need to run the football. That's not a smart decision.
I don't know what QB stats look like, but it can't be good.
It's third and 14. Ball on the 23. Here they come. Rolls to the right.
That's garbage.
Intercepted. Boy, the offense had an opportunity to get right.
Like, that was such garbage. Come on.
And their hopes look like they've been dashed now.
Everybody peeled off their route except for that guy. Oh my God.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line.
Just gotta keep him out of the end zone.
That'll push him over the 100-yard mark in receiving.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
From the 49-yard line, first down. Quick throw. He's hit and taken down.
It's really gonna make me sweat this shit out. Really?
Easy, easy, easy.
Oh, that was a pick. That was the ball game.
Defense had a chance here, Brad, to just end the drive. An interception there. They get the football back and a lot of momentum.
Second and 10. Ball on the 13-yard line.
Oh my fucking god. Dude. Absolute garbage, honestly. He's gonna go for two, isn't he? He's gonna. This little fucker. I swear to fucking god. If this little fucker wins. God damn, no fucking way. God. Holy.